In sports, Filipino boxing icon Manny Pacquiao set to return to the ring to take on Muay Thai legend Buakaw Banchamek. Now, the exhibition fight is scheduled for April 20 in Bangkok, Thailand. Dubbed the Match of Legends, the showdown boasts a budget of 1.36 billion pesos. The fight will have 6 3-minute rounds with 2-minute breaks in between. Now, at 41, Buakaw has had a decorated Muay Thai and kickboxing career, accumulating over 240 wins across a 24-year career. Taiwan offering more opportunities for Filipino workers, not just abroad, but also at home. Zen Hernandez reports.
Over 80% of the more than 150,000 overseas Filipino workers in Taiwan are employed in manufacturing. Leonard Asingwa is one of them. He has been working in Taiwan for 11 years and has no plans of going back to the Philippines anytime soon.
Napakalaking bagay po sa aming mga OFW dito sa Taiwan. Saka dito, lalo na po sa health insurance nila. Wala silang pinipili. OFW ka man, anong lahi ka man. Pag dyan ako sa Pinas, yung sasahurin ko ng isang buwan, hindi siya kakayanin mamasukurutan yung anak ko.
The Philippines is Taiwan's third biggest source of foreign workers, and it still needs some 80,000 more. Most of the demand is in the semiconductor industry.
Maybe you are aware that Taiwan currently produces more than 60% of the semiconductor chips of the world, and 92% of those advanced chips of the world. And we need more laborers, yeah, and skilled workers.
The Taiwan Economic and Cultural Official disclosed that it is arranging a meeting between its Ministry of Labor officials and the Philippine Department of Migrant Workers. Apart from manufacturing, Taiwan also has a need for other professionals, particularly English teachers. This is due to a bilingual policy which aims to make Taiwan an English and Mandarin Chinese speaking nation by 2030.
And they give very good remuneration. For English teachers there, I think our teachers get as high as 150,000.
All valid and approved job orders in any country are listed on the migrant workers website. For Taiwan, available job orders at the moment include factory workers, nursing aides, caretakers, and farm workers. But aside from recruiting workers to Taiwan, Taiwan is also hoping to bring the investment here in the Philippines, which is why TECO has been also lobbying for the removal of double taxation.
We already have some electronic manufacturers already invested it here. Yeah, we want more of this because you have many not skilled workers. Yeah, there's no need for further training.
Okay, and then agriculture
is another area.
Taiwan also opened a demonstration farm in Tarlac to aid in the training of Filipino farmers and possible Taiwanese investment in agriculture. Zen Hernandez, ABS-CBN News.